We're going to allow you one radical change in the NFL. You will be able to do one change. It could be a rule. It could be a CBA. It could be anything. But, Tom, you get to make one structural change to the game that you love, but there's currently something you don't love. What would it be? And Tom gave a five-minute answer, and here's a clip of it.
I think that what's happened over the last 10, 15 years, and I think in the it's a great question, because the game that I played 20 years ago is very different than the game now, in the sense that now it's more skills competition than it is physical football. I think in some ways they're taking away a physical element to the game that was the only way at one point to beat skill was to be tough. And when we played the Pittsburgh Steelers, they were tough. And when we played the teams that were just skillful, we won. And I think what's happening now is the way the rules are being set, I don't think that it's always in the best interests of the game that I once played. I feel like rules are being made. For example, the one is an example is there the onus of protecting another player is now on the opponent as opposed to on yourself. So, for example, I threw a touchdown pass. The 600 touchdown pass I ever threw in my career was to Mike Evans yesterday. 10 years ago, I never would have thrown that football because Mike had caught the ball. The safety was standing right there, and the safety essentially can't hit him the way that he used to be able to hit him because all the safeties now are 200 pounds, and they all cover. There's a lot of players like Ray Lewis that I didn't throw the ball between the hashes because Ray Lewis was going to knock him out of the game, not because, you know, he was going to, you know, make a tackle. And I think the onus of protecting receivers should be on the quarterback, not on the defensive backs. And the onus of protecting a running back should be on the offensive linemen, not on the tacklers who are trying to tackle the running back. So I don't believe in cheap shots, and I don't think cheap shots should ever be allowed. But if you are a professional athlete, it'd be like being in a boxing ring and saying, don't hit your opponent too hard because you might hurt him.
And who would have thought after 365 long days, we'd be walking into that stadium in what seemed like one day later, just like that, to play that very same team with the very same stakes.
Take a look around. Take a look around. We've been here before. We've been here before. But now it's our time.
We walked into a locker room and said, throw away the key. Lock the gates. Tonight they won't get out of this one.
Just schooled them, and the Ravens have their first lead of the night.
Long game. It's going to be a long game to get the things fixed.
We were jabbing and punching and throwing shots, and it was going back and forth. But we all knew going into halftime that the fight style was going to have to change.
Hey guys, we got to get something going.
We changed our style. We went from Joe Frazier to Muhammad Ali. We opened it up.
The Ravens' defense made sure the Patriots' offense was anything but comfortable.
We was hitting them. We was hitting them. The game became physical.
Inside handoff. Ridley's the 45. Oh, big hit. Ball came out. Ball is loose. And the Ravens have recovered.
That's how you do it.
That was the moment where we recaptured our defense, the Ravens' defense. And it wasn't just that play, but Bernard, in that play, kind of encapsulated the whole thing for us. That's who we are as a defense.
Let's finish this.
The Ravens outscored New England 21-0 in the second half, avenging their defeat from a year ago and earning a trip to New Orleans.